And I can remember on the training course I went on, we were taken down to the General Post Office in London, and we were introduced to a collection of men who were sitting at a long wooden table, and each man had a kettle, and on the kettle was a long spout, and he had a knitting needle, and they were opening the mail. They were intercepting communications. Now, you guys all know what intercepting communications means now, and it's not blokes with kettles opening the letters. So the world was a much simpler place, but we did gather the intelligence in those means. And still, I think human sources are probably one of the most important sources of intelligence, even in today's technological world with everything you guys can supply. Because the point about human sources, of course, is they can not only tell you what's going on, they can tell you what might be going to go on. They can tell you what people are thinking. And that's something that you can't really get from any kind of technological device. It was rather, actually, what was going on in London in those days was rather like a James Bond novel, for those of you who read that sort of thing. People were leaving money in hollow, in bricks, behind loose bricks in walls or in hollow trees on Hampstead Heath in return for secret documents. I mean, this was before you guys were ever invented and there were more technical ways of passing intelligence. In those days, spying was people. It wasn't emanations in the atmosphere. But now I think the world is in a very, very troubled state. And I would just like to say that we oldies, as we sit in our rocking chairs in front of the fire, are relying on all of you to make the world a safer, dare I say, simpler, kinder place for our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren than it's been for us. So thank you very much indeed for listening. Thank you.